Hill. Is this on?
Why don't you go back to No Man's Land, where you can mentally prepare and teach your ass whoop this Saturday at WrestleMania.
Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of What's Wrong With Wrestling. I'm Andrew Pisano, along with Eric Slamilton Hamilton. Good to see you again.
Good to see you too. Yeah. I've seen you consistently since Friday.
That's right.
Every day.
Yes.
So.
Ooh.
The time is upon us.
Yes.
It's finally here.
Uh-huh.
You're all going to get to witness it. This is it. The first ever What's Wrong With Wrestling trailer reaction video. Right? That's why we're here, right?
We should. We really should.
I mean, we really should.
So I've already had, there was a fan that reached out that said, please don't spoil the trailer. So I guess we shouldn't spoil the trailer, but the trailer was awesome.
The trailer was incredible.
Yeah. Maybe once we start the, you know, the film TV podcast, which is actually called Hollywood Hogwash.
Yes.
It's a take on an old Simpsons joke, but
yeah.
The podcast is called Hollywood Hogwash. It's coming soon. You could follow it on social media, Hollywood Hog Pod.
Mm.
At Hollywood Hog Pod.
Hog Pod.
Because on Twitter, Hollywood Hogwash is one letter too long.
Really?
Yeah. You can't have it that long, so Hollywood Hog Pod.
Huh.
Yeah. So go follow that. There's really nothing on it right now except for like the logo, which John David Guerra did for us, and he's just like he did, you know, the What's Wrong With Wrestling logo.
Yes.
But yeah, go check it out. That'll be coming soon. And when that drops, when we finally start that, we'll be doing trailer reactions on there.
Yeah.
So that'll be pretty cool.
Right.
Yeah.
And this was just the official teaser trailer.
Yes.
So this isn't like the official trailer.
No.
So that'll probably be out in like, what, a month or two?
You would think. I mean, shit. When the movie's come out in December? Like, is it on Christmas that's coming out?
Fingers crossed. It's like December 19th or
December
something.
December
19th. Yeah.
Okay. Wow. Yeah, I was so psyched.
Oh.
I am so psyched. So hyped.
I got home yesterday and ate dinner and immediately passed out for like almost 4 hours. I was so exhausted.
Right.
And I woke up and I had like multiple texts about the Spider-Man trailer.
Yeah.
So I had to get up and, you know, do what every normal person does and watch it 10 times in a row.
Of course.
And, oh, so glorious.
Yes, it is. For me, yesterday we did the SummerSlam recap. Then I had to watch TakeOver. Josh came over, recap TakeOver, edit that, put it up there. After that, I was exhausted. I slept till like noon today.
Nice.
So, yeah. It was much needed.
Yeah.
Much needed. And, you know, we're only recapping Raw this week because we already did SmackDown on Friday with the Rampage, the debut of CM Punk on Rampage and all that.
Yes.
So it's not going to be as long of a show. But, you know, this was not a good episode of Raw.
Mm-hmm.
But it wasn't as bad as Raw has been for, like, the past, you know, few months at least. Like, it was like, oh, it wasn't that bad. Now,
no, it was all bad.
Let me just say there was one horrendous thing that happened on the show that we'll get to.
Uh-huh.
But, like, overall, it wasn't rematch after rematch after rematch, at
right,
least
yeah.
for 1 week.
Yeah.
There was one. The main event was a rematch. But, like, it wasn't as bad as it's been. There were some bright spots. Now, the worst spot was, it's a fucking terrible moment. But, like, you know, it wasn't that bad.
It wasn't horrendous.
Yeah. Except for that one moment, which I have been seething about ever since I fucking saw it.
Yeah.
It was so unbelievable. Anyways, before we get to all that, we have to thank some new patrons.
Yes.
And we have a lot this week.
We do.
Because SummerSlam was a big show, big disappointing show.
Yes.
So we got 10 new patrons
and
that had to
just
sign up.
The wrestling.
Yes, that's right.
Apparently, I didn't know this. The toilets weren't working in the stadium.
You know what's funny? I don't think I ever went to the restroom the whole time we were there.
I don't think I did either.
Yeah. And we were there for like 5 hours.
Right. Well, that's I only had one beer.
Yeah, and I had one soda because we waited so long for drinks.
Yeah.
The whole credit card system was down. They only take credit cards, so you couldn't buy anything with cash. So eventually, like towards the end of the night, they just gave everyone one slice of pizza and a soda.
Yeah.
And like Eric was in our seats, and I was like, oh, I'll get us some food. I'll bring you some food. What do you want? Eric's like, oh, whatever. I come back with one slice of pizza and a drink, and you're like, what the fuck? Yeah. And I'm like, dude, I tried to get two slices. They wouldn't give it to me.
No.
So it was a big clusterfuck at Allegiant Stadium.
It really was. You were trying to get us cheesesteaks, too.
Yeah.
Cheesesteaks. So
right.
On top of all of that booze.
That's right. Anyways, but Vegas was a fun trip. You know, we met a bunch of fans for the pregame at SummerSlam, and that was way more fun than the actual pay-per-view.
For sure, for sure.
Here's the other thing about SummerSlam. WWE put out this press release saying SummerSlam is the most watched pay-per-view in WWE history. They put that out today. Here's the problem. SummerSlam isn't a pay-per-view anymore. That's like, it's not a pay-per-view. It's on Peacock. You don't have to pay per view it.
Yeah.
It's not
a
pay-per-view anymore. And Eric gets Peacock for free, just like so many people do, because you're Comcast. You have Comcast TV or Xfinity TV.
Yeah.
Everyone that has Xfinity television gets Peacock for free. I'm sure there's a bunch of other type of subscriptions where you also get Peacock for free.
Right.
Like, that's not a brag. This is not what it... that it doesn't mean what they're actually trying to say.
Yeah.
It's not a pay-per-view.
And as many of those people who probably were watching for the first time, like, just feel bad. Like,
right.
You put out a show like this.
Yes.
Like, there was no grandeur to it.
No.
None at all.
No.
The set, the quote-unquote set.
There was no
was
set.
Was garbage.
The set?
Who are you?
What are you talking right, yeah. about?
The RK-Bro celebration
yeah.
had more pyro
yes.
than SummerSlam.
That's right.
The whole thing.
Because SummerSlam had zero pyro.
Yeah.
Zero. Zero. What the fuck
Not
happened?
Even like opening show fireworks.
I was waiting. I expected we'd have some rumors today on what went wrong
right.
for SummerSlam. But there's no reports. It's almost as if like they did this on purpose.
Yeah.
How could you possibly do SummerSlam like this? It's in a football stadium. Everyone's expecting it to be like WrestleMania because you put it in a football stadium.
Exactly.
But it was not.
No.
It was not like a WrestleMania. There was like zero production value.
Yeah, right.
If you watched at home, you got more because you got CGI snakes, CGI Lily the doll.
Right. You know, shit you want.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, like...
that weird CGI thing of Roman going, ooh-ah.
Yeah.
It looks so fucking weird.
I know. Like, but, if you're gonna do it in a football stadium, you've got to do something.
Yes.
You have to put something out there.
Right.
And, I mean, they tarped off, like, a third of the arena.
Yeah.
Like, they were going to set something up.
Because they couldn't sell tickets. And then they tried to brag about how many tickets they sold. Which, in the press release... They put the fake number in the press release.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous.
I know.
Oh. I mean, if you were there in person, you were like, wow, it's like, it's almost as if no one's here. There's so many empty seats.
Yeah.
It's crazy. But go check out our SummerSlam recap and our TakeOver recap at patreon.com/whatswrongwithwrestling. We're going to get to the names right now. We got 10 new patrons. Thank you to Nate Smythe Jr.
Yes.
His father, who we met in Vegas... was already a longtime patron,
uh-huh.
and now his son is also a patron.
So, first multi-generational patrons.
That's right.
How crazy is that?
Yes. That is fantastic.
Yeah. Nate was probably like, why is this already like halfway listened to? Like, right. Get your own feed.
Yeah. Yeah. We also want to thank Chelsea Wallace, Milton Danglewitz, Jamie P., Joey Jojo Jr. Shabadoo. Derek Snyder, Mario Rizzo, Garrett Mulholland, and then Bill Capri and Mark Horsfield got year subs.
Fantastic.
Bill Capri and Mark Horsfield, year subscriptions at patreon.com/whatswrongwithwrestling. It's $5 a month minimum for all the content. You can cancel anytime, but if you do a year sub, it's $9 off for the year.
Yeah.
So if you want to save some money... if you know you're going to hang around,
yeah,
then do the year sub. And if you, you know, if you're not sure, go to patreon.com/whatswrongwithwrestling, sign up for 1 month. If you regret it, I'll refund you. But give it a try.
Yeah.
patreon.com/whatswrongwithwrestling.
Trust me, $5 can go like that on That's anything. Right. I spent $5 like that in Vegas on a slot machine.
Of course. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Just don't play the slots.
Yeah.
For 1 day.
Exactly. Or 1 minute.
Yeah. Or don't get like a cookie with your lunch.
Yeah.
You know, and you can just sign up on Patreon for
right,
a month.
Yeah.
There you go. We also have three fans that bought t-shirts at prowrestlingtees.com/whatswrongwithwrestling. Greg Lister and Orlando Alvarado bought
pizza.
That's right. And then Justin Morales got
a gay, a gay, a gay.
Which is, you know, more relevant than ever. Especially for SummerSlam.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think half the matches were rematches.
At least.
So, yeah, that's, again, prowrestlingtees.com/whatswrongwithwrestling and patreon.com/whatswrongwithwrestling. Go check it out.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so Monday Night Raw opens with Bobby Lashley and MVP. MVP says, we all know about Goldberg's extraordinary history in this industry.
Bottom right?
Yeah.
Who are you?
Okay.
But we also know about his recent not-so-extraordinary history.
Uh-huh.
That's
a little... Since he came back.
Right, like a little too real, right?
Right.
WWE?
Yeah.
Because, I mean, it's been nothing but shit.
Right.
It's been absolute shit since he came back in 2016. God,
yeah.
That's how long it's been. The end of 2016 is when he squashed Brock Lesnar at Survivor Series. And I'll never forget, you jumped up and it was like maybe the hardest you've ever laughed.
It was.
Yeah.
Because it was like 30 seconds or something.
Yeah.
Just a couple spears.
Right.
Like,
it's ridiculous.
Right.
So MVP says the Almighty beat the holy hell out of Goldberg and he quit, and that makes him a coward. Then he was attacked from behind by Goldberg's son, Torque, or as Eric likes to call him.
Yes.
And that's how we call him now.
Yeah.
You know, if you didn't listen to the SummerSlam recap, Eric thought Goldberg's son's name was Torque.
Not Gage.
Hey, Gage? What are you talking about?
Who are you?
Yeah, Don't ever say that name.
Yeah.
Don't ever say that name.
So, Goldberg's son, Torque.
His name is Torque.
Yeah.
He attacked Lashley, and he said Lashley did to him what he would do to anyone who hopped the barricade. He put him to sleep.
That's true, though.
So if you think Lashley owes Goldberg or Torque an apology, champ, and then Lashley says, you can go to hell, Torque.
Yeah.
And,
fuck you, Torque.
Fuck you, Torque. Then the new United States champion, Damian Priest, comes out to defend Goldberg and call Lashley the coward for attacking Goldberg after their match. That'll get Priest over. Defend Goldberg.
Yeah, right. Everyone loves that guy.
Everyone likes Priest right now, but
right. We kind of like Lashley right now because he injured Goldberg. So.
Exactly. Now Priest is like, hey man, don't talk bad about Goldberg.
Don't talk bad about that 72-year-old man.
Yeah, and Torque's my best friend.
So watch what you say about Torque.
Torque and Priest.
Yeah, Priest then challenges Lashley to a match and says, if you don't accept, then you're the coward.
Oh,
Lashley attacks Priest, but Priest kicks him out of the ring, and then MVP says, Lashley's gonna go change, and he's gonna come back and whoop your behind.
Okay.
And he walks to the back. Now, they did this during the Thunderdome era. Like, Lashley would leave, go get changed during the commercial break. But it's weird to do that in front of fans.
Right.
When we come back from commercial, Bobby Lashley has his grand entrance again.
Yeah.
That he had to open the show.
Right.
Like, a full entrance.
Yeah.
And we have Bobby Lashley versus Damian Priest. A few minutes into the match, Sheamus runs out and attacks Priest for the DQ.
Mm.
Great.
So that's not over.
No. Lashley and Sheamus start beating up Priest together, but then Drew McIntyre runs out and makes the save.
I thought he couldn't fight Lashley anymore.
No, just not for the title. He could fight him, but not for the title.
Okay.
And plus, they're like, who else is here? There's
right.
No one else. We fired everyone.
Yeah. Who else are you?
It's kind of funny. WWE went from having too much talent to not enough.
Because
they have three shows.
Yeah.
If they had one show, they would still have plenty of talent.
Yeah.
But they have three shows, not enough talent. Yeah, Priest clotheslines Sheamus over the barricade and McIntyre suplexes Lashley onto the announce table. And you know what that means.
Uh-oh.
Commercial break. And then we have Drew McIntyre and Damian Priest versus Bobby Lashley and Sheamus.
Restart that match.
Vince is like, how do we make one segment three segments? Lashley and MVP will come out. And then Priest will challenge him to a match. They'll have the match. Then it's a DQ. Then he'll run out. He'll run out. And then we'll have a tag team match. Ha! I'm a genius. Oh, wait. I have that sound button.
Yeah.
I'm a genius.
Yeah.
Yes.
Fucking tag team match. Sheamus hits McIntyre with white noise off the second rope, but Drew kicks out. Then MVP convinces Lashley to bail on Sheamus. And McIntyre hits Sheamus with the Claymore for the win. Later, Sheamus confronts Lashley backstage, and they're going to face each other next week. And also later in the show, McIntyre tells Priest, "We're going out drinking tonight. First pint's on you." And he walks away, and Priest is like, "Make sure you wear pants." And McIntyre's like, "This is how I'm going out." It's like, you know, he's going to wear a Speedo at the bar.
Yeah, right.
At least show that, you know, it'd be pretty funny.
It would. I mean, I imagine, you know, his official dress code now is his kilt, so.
Yes, that's right.
Probably wearing a kilt.
He'll bring the sword to the bar. Of course. Like, oh my God!
He's like, look at the bar trick I can do.
Yeah, but that's the first.
Kills the guy.
That's the first half hour of Raw.
Yeah.
So, there you go. You know what? I forgot. It's your birthday's coming up in a few days, and you gave me my birthday gift last week.
That's true.
So I forgot to do this at the open of the show because we were talking about SummerSlam and all that stuff.
And Spider-Man.
And patreon.com/whatswrongwithwrestling.
SpiderSlam.
Yeah, I got you your gift. Just give me 1 second. Hold on. Don't look.
All right.
I haven't wrapped it yet. I'm going to wrap it right now.
All right.
Hold on. I bought some wrapping. I got some wrapping for it.
Okay.
Hold on 1 second here. It's almost done. Wow. All right.
Sounds wrapping.
And it doesn't fit in the box I got for it. Well, here, there you go.
Oh,
there you go,
oh,
buddy.
Oh, wow, cool box. Cool
yeah,
box.
Yeah.
Wow, this is like
shrunk
wrap. What is that?
Well, open it up. Oh, is it like you have to like rip it open? I guess
so.
Yeah. Here, I'll get rid of this wrapping that I bought for you.
No problem. Way to go. Wow, that is...
Here, just put your finger in it. Oh, it is fucking... Oh, yeah, it is really...
Someone
actually,
check that audio.
It really is too hard to open yourself.
There we go.
Okay. All right.
When in doubt, use the key.
Here we go. He's opening the gift. It's a... Simpsons blanket!
It's like a cape blanket.
Yeah, you put it on your head. It's almost like a Snuggie. Yeah, it looks pretty good.
Mm. Yeah. I love all the like Simpsons faces too.
Yeah.
Let's go ahead and talk about every character and panel in this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the Simpsons.
So there's Lisa. There's a
Catalog.
Sears Catalog. No, this is cool. Where'd you get this? I like this.
Amazon. Yeah.
So I'm going to wear this the whole show.
Okay, then.
All right.
Sounds good.
Yeah. Hey, everyone. Come to YouTube and see how good I look.
Yeah. It fits you perfectly, too.
It does.
Definitely not too small.
It's definitely not for a child.
Damn it. Anyways, next up, Sheriff Schreiber interviews Doudrop backstage. And listen to the reaction from the WWE Universe. They love her.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my guest at this time, Doudrop.
Whoa! Oh my, did CM Punk return?
Right.
Wow, what a CM Punk-like pop for Doudrop.
Yeah.
So we're still doing Thunderdome fake chants.
Right.
Fake crowd noise. Doudrop and the play. Oh my God!
Well, I mean, their recap videos have fake footage. So.
That's right. When they open of Raw, they recap the biggest moments of SummerSlam. They showed Brock Lesnar come out.
Uh-huh.
And then they cut to footage of fans cheering. And it was me from Money in the Bank in Fort Worth. And it was when Cena came out. They used footage of me. When Cena came out, the guy in front of me is doing the Abadu.
Yeah.
He's holding up the fucking John Cena hand signals.
Uh-huh.
It's like, how would this be Lesnar?
Right.
So.
That is so hilarious. Of all the footage.
Right.
They could have used.
Yeah.
They used Money in the Bank footage.
Yeah.
That just happened to have you on it.
I was like, well, there I am, like, close to the ring. In my Deadpool shirt. No, I wasn't wearing Deadpool shirt at SummerSlam.
And I wasn't close to the ring. So, like, you're just watching. You're like, wait a second.
Yeah.
Was that?
You know what I saw? I didn't even notice my face at first. I noticed the Deadpool shirt.
Oh.
Yeah.
You're like, hey, I had that shirt.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, I had that face.
Right. Well, it's like one of our friends, he's forever what was it when he was at a Raw that The Rock played a guitar and sung the song to Vicky Guerrero, and like called her a fucking slut or whatever it was,
right,
like
yeah,
ugly
yeah.
as shit, and then they cut to him laughing. Well, now that clip was like forever changed to when R-Truth came out, and what was it? He thought he was going to be in Money in the Bank, but he wasn't even in the match. And then they used his reaction for the art for that R-Truth moment.
Oh, really?
Like forever, yeah, yeah. So
interesting.
If this is not the first time they've done this. They do this shit all the time.
Yeah, right.
It's like on purpose. But anyways, here's the Doudrop's interview.
Doudrop, can you explain what happened between you and Eva Marie at SummerSlam?
First of all, I made a mistake associating myself with Eva Marie. She helped me get my foot in the door here at Monday Night Raw. But I didn't sign up to get spoken down to and treated like I'm worthless. She thought she put me down by giving me the name Doudrop. Well, I like that name. That's who I am now. I'm Doudrop. And the next time I see Eva Marie, I'm gonna Doudrop her. I'm gonna make Eva Marie feel like how she tried
it. I'm gonna make Eva Marie feel like. So she likes the name Doudrop.
Oh, that's funny because no one else does.
Like Shorty G. Like, you know what? I like Shorty G. I'm gonna go with Shorty G.
Yeah.
I like my poo poo name. I like my shit name.
I like being made fun of.
Yeah.
Who needs the name Piper?
Right. So, and also somehow Doudrop didn't see Eva Marie pushing a crate right in front of her. She didn't even attack her from behind. No. She was right to her.
Rolling a giant crate into her.
Yeah.
From front POV.
It's like I'm facing you doing an interview and then someone comes right here and I don't see it until it happens.
Right.
The fuck?
Yeah, come on. Come on.
The stage blocking has never been good in WWE for a long time.
Right.
So,
and I think it's like, I still find it really weird that the backstage interview thing is like, it's kind of like that stand that Stone Cold is on.
Yes. That's it. It's just like a fourth of a wrestling ring.
Right.
Ah! I just killed Stone Cold. Yeah, that's all this is. It's like, hey, what's up? You were in this wrestling ring, kind of, not really.
Yeah. Let's do interviews here.
Yeah. Like, strange.
Okay.
I don't know. Anyways, Eva bashed Doudrop's head into the crate multiple times, called her ungrateful, then put her foot on her and said, "This is evolution."
Thank you.
And then Eva walked away. Schreiber checked on Doudrop, and Doudrop said, "That bitch." Oh, damn.
Got him.
No, she didn't.
Didn't.
So they're going to fight next week.
Great.
Yeah.
Can't wait.
Hopefully Eva gets future endeavored after that.
Uh-huh.
What could she possibly do after that?
Right. Clearly.
She can't wrestle.
She's going to get another protege.
Like, she can't wrestle at all. She's like the female Goldberg.
Mm.
It's ridiculous.
Eva Berg.
This is Eva Berg.
Lucian.
Next up, we have Ricochet versus the new and improved Karrion Kross. Now, how do we describe...
Both of those are false.
New and improved should have sarcastic quotes around.
Mm.
Kross is dressed like he is the sex slave of Retribution.
Yes.
Like, let's pretend Retribution's back. We got Mace, T-Bar. And, like, as stupid as they look, like, Karrion Kross is their sex slave.
Yeah.
Like, they just fuck his mouth.
Right.
Whenever they want. And he's like, oh, please, please, can I have more? He's wearing a fucking gimp mask.
Yeah.
And as soon as they showed him, you could see the fans in the front row laughing at him.
Yeah.
Go back and watch. They were laughing at him because he looked fucking ridiculous.
Mm-hmm. He must have gotten, like, brain damage.
Sell the fucking company. Now,
right?
Please sell the fucking company.
Why can't we make any future stars?
Yeah.
Oh, who's this? Oh, you're put on this stupid fucking mask, you piece of shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then it felt like they had more Thunderdome booze during this match because, you know, the fans didn't care, but like the booze were like Roman Reigns just beat The Undertaker at WrestleMania.
I know.
It was ridiculous.
Right.
Cross hits the Doomsday Suplex. That's what it's called now.
Oh.
It used to be called the Doomsday Saito. And then he puts Ricochet to sleep with the cross jacket. It used to be the straight jacket, but straight jacket, that's too... I can't have that. This is a family show. Yeah. Straight jackets aren't nice. It's a family show.
I thought it was always called the cross jacket.
It used to be the straight jacket.
Maybe on Raw, they've just been calling it cross
jacket. No, that's right. They've been calling it that on Raw. So, yeah. Cross wins. I think now he's 3-2 on the main roster, but he just lost the NXT championship to Samoa Joe. So this is who he is now.
Yeah.
He's the sex slave of retribution.
Uh-huh.
Dear God.
Yeah. He's pumped.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if I was him, like, you saw Zelina Vega got fired. She started in OnlyFans, right? Like, started in OnlyFans with Scarlett, you know? Get fired. 90 days later, you're in AEW.
Yeah.
Just do that.
Yeah.
Right. And where is Scarlett, by the way?
Everyone wins.
Scarlett is nowhere to be found.
Especially the fans.
They're going to make her a wrestler, even though she can't wrestle.
Yeah. Well, can she?
No.
No.
No. She's not a wrestler.
You've seen her matches?
She's a manager, yeah.
Oh.
I mean, a few. Like, there's been... I've seen clips.
Like in Impact?
Yeah. She got squashed by Nia Jax a few years ago.
Oh, really?
And she said her favorite wrestler was Sasha Banks. And I was like, you're like the same age. What are you... She's like acting like she was like a little girl. Like, my favorite wrestler is Sasha Banks. So, yeah. Next up, we have Moist TV with John Morrison. His guest is Logan Paul.
Yeah.
Morrison started to interview him, but The Miz interrupted because he's jealous. Miz says, everyone knows I'm Logan Paul's favorite WWE superstar, but Logan Paul says, actually, I like The New Day. And it felt like WWE didn't even know like who they wanted to be the face and the heel in this segment.
Right.
Because Logan Paul's being a dick. They're booing him.
Mm-hmm.
Then he says he likes The New Day, so it's like, okay, and I guess they want the crowd to cheer him for saying that. He likes The New Day. He promotes his brother's boxing fight against Tyron Woodley. And then Miz kisses Logan Paul's ass at first, but then asks, what round is your brother getting knocked out in?
Ha.
And it's like, that's a face thing for Miz to do.
Right.
Because no one likes Logan Paul.
Or Jake Paul.
Or Jake Paul, or any Paul. Paul gets in Miz's face and says, if you ask another question like that, Woodley's not going to be the only one getting knocked out this week. And then Morrison tells Miz, you're trying to make everything about you. And Miz calls Moist TV a ripoff of Miz TV. Oh, really?
Oh, you think?
Wow.
Where'd you deduct that one from, Sherlock?
And then they couldn't figure out how to end this segment. Logan Paul's just like, I'm going to go.
Can I go home now?
This is awkward.
Where do I get my money?
I'm going to go. And then Miz and Morrison argue some more, and then Xavier Woods comes out, and we have The Miz versus Xavier Woods. Morrison soaks the floor. Miz tries to throw Woods, but Woods throws Miz into the water, and Miz slides into the steel steps.
Mm.
Later, Morrison gets on the apron to try to squirt on Woods, but he ducked. Then The Miz rolled up Woods, but the ref was busy yelling at Morrison for being on the apron. Woods eventually kicks out. Miz complains, but then Woods beats Miz with a... roll up.
Yeah. Does Woods have a finisher by himself?
By himself?
Yeah. Where's Kofi?
Yeah, I don't know. Kofi wasn't at SummerSlam either.
Yeah.
After the match, Miz attacks Morrison from behind, brutally beats him up, and then gives him the skull-crushing finale. So some good came of this because at least Goofy Miz is gone.
Yeah, that's true.
We got serious Miz back.
Right.
You know, he's not going to be...
Serious Miz-ness.
Serious Miz-ness. And Serious Heel Miz is the best version of Miz.
Correct.
The best variant of Miz.
Yeah, I was tired of this, like, water spraying bullshit.
Yeah. And then Morrison later cut a backstage promo vowing to get revenge on Miz next week, so...
Okay.
Like, at least we're not getting a bunch of rematches, you know? Like, that's the positive that I'm looking at. It's like, it's not...
Right.
It's actually still not a good show, but it's just... At least it's not the same bad show that we watch week after week after week.
And I'm sure they'll give a good match at Extreme Rules.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Those two.
Extreme Rules and then Saudi Mania.
Uh-huh.
Survivor Series.
Right.
Yeah.
What's
TLC?
What other pay-per-views in October?
October is hold on. September's Extreme Rules. October is Saudi Mania.
No, but that's always like a special show. They also do a pay-per-view.
Well, I don't think they've announced one.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Mm.
I think it might just be Saudi Mania this year.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, there you go. Earlier today, we see Reggie visit an ice cream truck, and he tells us that he could never afford ice cream as a kid. It's like $1.
Yeah.
Especially when you were a kid.
Right. Reggie. Come on.
He says, now that I'm the 24/7 champion, I could have all the ice cream I want. Yeah. Being the 24/7 champ, that's where the money's at.
Yeah.
Being the 24/7
champion. Making the big bucks.
And then R-Truth and Akira Tozawa, they're dressed as a garbage can and Sasquatch because obviously they filmed all these segments like the same day.
Right.
And they're just stretching these out for weeks.
Months.
They try to attack him, but Reggie distracts them by giving them ice cream. Then Reggie climbs up a tree, jumps to the ground, miraculously jumps to the top of the ice cream truck.
Uh-huh. Somehow.
There was a fucking trampoline.
They're just fucking everywhere.
Then he flips off the ice cream truck. He did all this to get away from Truth and Tozawa, right?
Right.
Then what does he do? He runs right in the middle of them.
Mm-hmm.
He runs in between them, hops in the ice cream truck, and drives off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What?
Oh, wow.
What?
A lion.
Lions.
Birds! No, like, yeah, what are we doing here? Yeah. At least they're not doing this, like, in the ring or anything, but
right.
I hate this shit. It's
supposedly
so
October is Clash of Champions.
Oh.
Yeah.
Let me see. So, Saudi Mania is October 21st, Clash of Champions October ?
Yes.
They haven't announced it yet.
Negative.
Hmm. Okay. Survivor Series is at Barclays in Brooklyn.
Brooklyn.
Extreme Rules, September 26th in Columbus, Ohio.
Ohio.
Yeah. Ohio. And then what's... they don't have the day one... They announced the day one pay-per-view?
Yeah. In Atlanta.
In Atlanta. Whatever.
Can't wait.
All right, moving on. We have Jinder Mahal versus Mansoor with Mustafa Ali, Veer, and Shanky
ringside.
Where's Mason T-Bar? Their arch nemesis.
That's right.
Where are they at?
Probably fucking Karrion Kross.
Oh, yeah.
Tag-teaming him.
That makes sense.
Yeah. He's like, Karrion Kross sucks my dick. And Karrion Kross eats my ass.
Very well.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
Karrion Kross.
Lions.
Karrion Kross fucks me like a lion.
Jesus.
Anyways, backstage before the match, Mansoor tells Ali, don't help me out there. I want to win the right way. I don't want to cheat.
Okay.
So let's see what happens. Mahal gets disqualified for kicking Mansoor in the corner for too long. Then Ali gets in the ring and tells Mansoor, like he's pissed at him. And he's like, we could do things your way or we could do things my way. And I'm like, he won the match, right?
Right.
Like it was a DQ, but he won. He gets the bonus.
Yeah.
He won the match. Mm-hmm. And then Corey Graves said, things are starting to turn around for Jinder Mahal. He lost! He lost the match!
Moving on up.
Since when getting disqualified, you won?
Yeah.
What the fuck kind of insanely stupid logic is that?
Right.
Where's the logic there? Explain it! Because he beat him up, he lost the match. He has a loss. Oh, that's right. Wins and losses don't matter. That's the problem. They treated this whole thing like Mansoor's the idiot. He won the match. He won.
Right.
And Jinder Mahal leaves like,
that's right.
That's right.
Eat it. Suck it, bitches.
That's right. I'm not even good enough to beat Mansoor.
Boom.
My God.
Another loss.
Another loss. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Ain't Jinder Mahal. Right. Stinky.
Jinder Mahal bouncing back from almost getting decapitated. Yeah.
Yeah. Now he's just losing matches.
Right. Jesus. Next up, we have an in-ring promo from Charlotte Flair. Flair says, was there any doubt in anyone's mind that I wasn't going to be standing here again? You're Raw Women's Champion. Did she say again?
Again.
Yeah.
Again.
Right.
Again.
She calls herself a 12-time champion because they're not counting the two NXT titles.
Which is so weird.
I guess they just don't want her to get to 16 as fast.
Right, because now she'd be at, like, what, 14?
14.
Yeah.
So she's at 12.
But then why do they have her win the title for a week?
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
I mean, come on.
They had to blow that
cash
in.
She won it. She lost it the next night.
Yes.
And then she got it back a month later.
Right. Like, where's the creativity? Like, Charlotte's been cashed in 3 out of the 4 times.
Yeah.
2.
It's just, God, it's so...
Money in the Bank meant nothing.
It's ultimately so boring, you
Nikki's
know?
Nikki's not getting that title back.
No.
So Charlotte says, there isn't another woman that measures up to me, and I'm holding this title for as long as I can. Then they play her music for 20 seconds.
Uh-huh.
Pyro goes off. And then she continues her promo.
Yeah.
What?
I didn't get that.
No, not at all.
Yeah.
I didn't understand
like,
that.
Like, let's hear it for me again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then she keeps marking out for herself, finishes the promo for the second time, holds up the title, music plays again.
Yes.
But this time, Alexa Bliss comes out to the stage with her doll, and she says, congratulations, Charlotte. Lily and I just wanted to say hi.
Remember when The Fiend came out against Balor?
Yeah.
And he's just like, I just wanted to say hi.
Hi.
Hello. Hi.
Hi. Yeah.
I mean, that's it. Like, if you're going to steal the gimmick, live the fucking gimmick.
Right.
Like, stop with this watered down bullshit.
Here's the other
bullshit.
Thing. I don't think Alexa's beating Charlotte.
No. I don't think so.
You know?
Right.
Like, Alexa's pretty much lost every match except for Eva Marie.
Yeah.
Like, she, just like The Fiend, she still loses all the time.
Right.
The Fiend loses all the time.
Unlimited supernatural power can't win a wrestling match.
Right. Can't kick out of a 70-year-old spear.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I guess that's the Extreme Rules match, Alexa versus Charlotte. This will probably go on for a while. There's going to be more magic, more bullshit.
Probably a House of Horrors match.
And the only good thing will be Alexa dressed in another sexy outfit.
Sure.
For the pay-per-view.
Sure.
At least we'll have that.
Yeah, I guess.
Next up, we have Nia Jax and Shayna Baszler versus Nikki A.S.H. and Rhea Ripley.
Uh-huh.
Nikki A.S.H.
That new tag team.
Yes. Earlier in the show, Nikki found Ripley backstage, and she's like, will you be my tag partner against Nia and Shayna? And Ripley's like, okay, I guess. So we have this. Nia gave Nikki the stink face. I guess that's her move now.
Yeah,
it is. And Jimmy Smith said, this looks physically over right now. She put her ass in her face. I'm pretty sure she's dead.
Mm.
Nia and Shayna had a bunch of miscues, teasing that they're going to break up. Nikki dives off the top rope onto Nia on the floor, and then Rhea hits Shayna with the Riptide for the win.
Yeah.
Nikki jumps on Ripley after the match to celebrate, but Ripley feels uncomfortable.
As anyone would.
Yeah. So now we have 3 tag teams on Raw that are all doing the same angle.
Yes.
Riddle's like, hey, Randy, I love you. Randy's like, ugh. Then we have Mansoor. Hey, Mustafa Ali, I love you. And Ali's like, ugh. Now we have Nikki. Nikki, Rhea, I love you. And Rhea's like, ugh.
Yeah.
3 tag teams, same story.
I mean, if it ain't broke, give it to everyone.
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah, can't wait for Karrion Kross to team up with, like, Jeff Hardy.
Oh, my God.
And have that kind of relationship.
Yeah. And Jeff's like, what are you... I mean, I know I look stupid, but what are you wearing?
Right, yeah. Jesus.
Then next up, we have Riddle and Randy Orton's tag team championship celebration. Riddle comes out first and introduces Orton, who seems upset by all the balloons in the ring. Then Riddle tells... some, like, the ring announcer, he's like, hey, do the thing we talked about. And the ring announcer says, your new Raw Tag Team Champions, RK-Bro. And then a bunch of pyro goes off, and Randy seems impressed.
Mm-hmm.
Riddle then reveals that he bought Randy a scooter with purple tassels. And then Byron Saxton, this might have been the first time Byron Saxton ever made me laugh, but he legitimately made me laugh. He gives Randy the scooter, with the purple tassels, and Byron Saxton says, "I'm so jelly right now of Randy."
Could be worst comment or best comment.
I legitimately laughed. He got the scooter with purple tassels. I'm so jelly right now for Randy.
Jesus.
I fucking thought that was hilarious.
Yeah.
Then AJ...
it's the most Byron thing he's ever said.
Yeah. Then AJ Styles and Omos come out, and AJ tells Riddle, "You got Orton a scooter, but Randy didn't get you anything. But I got you a phenomenal forearm to wipe that stupid smile off your face."
Oh, that's nice.
And then Riddle tells Styles, "I'm going to beat you with the three most destructive letters in WWE, RK-Bro," and Orton face palms, and Styles yells, "That's not three letters!"
Right.
So, I like the segment.
Yeah.
You know, I thought this was some of the best RK-Bro stuff we've had.
Yeah.
So I did like it. And then we got AJ Styles versus Riddle.
Rematch,
I mean, we have to be honest.
After rematch, after rematch, after rematch, after rematch.
Like 2 weeks ago?
Last week, right? Last week they had
this. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Or was it? Yeah, whatever.
No, it was last week. Yeah, because you did the Styles Clash.
Well, we've seen Styles versus Riddle again since Riddle's been on the main roster. It's been like a constant thing. They feuded three times. So Styles picks up Riddle, but Riddle counters, giving Styles a Hurricane Rana, and they both go over the top rope to the floor. That was a nice spot. Later, Riddle goes to the second rope, and just like last week, he once again stops to stare at Omos, and then Styles knocks him down. Orton goes after Omos, but Omos throws Orton into the barricade. Then AJ sets up for the Styles Clash, but then Orton attacks Omos with his new scooter. And this distracts Styles, and then Riddle hits the Broderick for the win. Orton celebrates with Riddle, and then he gives AJ an RKO. And then Orton and Riddle pose together to end the show. So at least the end of the show was good.
Yeah.
You know, like it was fun. That segment they had was fun. And
what was the segment absolutely hated?
Karrion Kross. Well, just the Karrion Kross.
Okay. Oh, yeah. All right.
You know, obviously that.
Gotcha.
So, you know. At least we had some fun on Raw.
Yeah.
Orton and Riddle. One fun. That's still more than usual.
It is.
Usually it's no fun.
It's almost a high. A right. Record high.
Yeah. All right, let's give some awards.
Yeah.
Who'd you have for worst dress?
Oof. This was really tough.
Yeah.
I went with a former NXT champion.
Yeah.
Karrion Kross.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think his name is going to be Fuckboy Kross next
week. Fuckboy Kross, yeah.
Fuckboy Kross.
I also had Fuckboy Kross.
Okay.
Best dressed?
Eva Marie.
All right. I went with Alexa Bliss.
Okay.
Worst acting?
Logan Paul.
That is correct.
Yeah.
Best acting?
I had AJ Styles.
Okay.
Yeah.
This might sound weird, but I actually thought he was good this week. I had Riddle.
Right.
I thought he was funny. So yeah, he wasn't like overly stupid, you know, like it wasn't normal Riddle. I thought he was good.
Yeah.
Worst comment?
I went with Doudrop embracing her new name.
Yes, sweep it.
Who the fuck wants to be called Doudrop?
Right, it's dumb. But yeah. At this point, it's like, well, everyone knows her as Doudrop, so we can't just change her name.
Right. I mean, they could. They've done it.
Right.
Literally done it, but yeah. Whatever.
Best comment?
I guess the purple tassels. I'm so jelly. So jelly right now.
Yeah, that's what I had. Yeah. Worst match?
Mansoor versus Jinder.
Yup.
Okay.
Super slow-mo.
Naya and Shayna versus Rhea and Nikki.
Yep. This is easy this week, especially when there's only one show.
Yeah, I know.
Best match?
I went with Priest and McIntyre versus Bobby and Sheamus, just because it was four guys who hadn't really... Like, okay. It was cool seeing Priest interact with Lashley.
Oh, Lashley.
Okay. Yeah.
I had Styles Riddle, even though we've seen it a million times.
Right.
Worst move?
My whole sound button.
Oh, yes.
Nice, like, take my hole.
Yes.
Take it.
Here we go. This is, yeah, the Nia Sting face.
Yeah.
Best move?
I didn't really have anything. What'd you have?
I just had the RKO to Styles.
Okay.
That Orton gave him.
Yeah.
Nice way to end the show.
Right. That could work.
Worst moment or segment?
Mine was actually Charlotte's promo.
Okay.
Yeah.
It was long.
It was long. Mid pyro for some reason.
That was weird.
Alexa came out, did nothing. Yeah.
I just had seeing Karrion Kross.
Yeah. What? I'm not mad at you for that.
Fuck.
Yeah.
Best moment or segment?
RK Bro.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah.
That was easy.
It was. Not totally painful.
Yeah. All right, breaking news.
Did you hear this one?
So Nikki Bella was supposedly going to be in attendance for SummerSlam, but she wasn't there.
Mm-hmm.
And she took to Instagram originally to post a few pictures, and she said, "When you're not allowed to go to SummerSlam in Vegas, LOL." So people were like, "Well, what happened?"
Yeah.
Was she invited and then not invited? But then she later spoke to the TV show Extra, and she claimed that she was too busy winning big at roulette, and that's why she missed the show. So obviously that was a lie.
Right.
She's clearly bitter because something went wrong where she wasn't allowed at the show.
Yeah.
Or like maybe she thought she was going to get comped tickets and didn't. But something feels weird.
Maybe she just tried to show up backstage.
But why couldn't she do that? Like, she has a TV show that's with WWE, right? Bellas is still a thing.
Yes.
Just seems weird, because also there's John Laurinaitis is her stepdad.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I know.
Seems a little weird.
I know that they had seats down there, so.
She also shit on SummerSlam.
Oh, yeah?
She shit on Becky Lynch squashing Belair. She said what every fan said. You built up Belair for a year just to squash her.
Yeah, right.
So, yeah, she's clearly upset.
I don't blame her.
You got anything?
Yeah, so in typical WWE fashion, they did more Corbin videos.
Oh, right.
And did not put him on the show. Mm-mm. There was a few videos released where Corbin was like, "I turned $35 into $100.
Yeah.
And then later he's won
thousands
of dollars and gets a comp presidential suite.
Right.
And he finally buys a new shirt and is eating steak. And then something happens and he was in a pay by the hour motel.
Yeah. He was completely broke again.
Yeah.
It was funny.
Right. So I don't know why they won't air these. These are fucking great.
Right.
Other than that, I don't really have.
Oh, the other thing was WWE President Nick Khan did a sit-down interview with Ariel Helwani, who covers MMA. That's his main thing.
Uh-huh.
But he covered WWE SummerSlam over the weekend, and he also had a sit-down interview with Nick Khan, and he asked him, about all the releases, and, Nick Khan, it was just a bunch of, bullshit answers. He was like, "Well, you know, sometimes wrestlers leave," and it's like, "Well, no, they didn't leave. You fired them."
Yeah.
And Mickey James even, made fun of his outfit. He was like, "Hey, she said, the Sopranos called. They want their big pussy back."
Big bushy. Big bushy.
Big bushy.
And Helwani also asked him, "What show do you think's better, Raw or SmackDown?" He was like, "I think both are terrific shows." And he asked him, "Should Raw be 3 hours? Uh-huh. And Nick Khan said, "I think Raw should be 4 hours and SmackDown would be 8 hours because then we'd get more money."
So clearly Nick Khan's a fucking mental patient.
Yeah.
It's like, I want to see you sit through this 3-hour show.
Right. But it was just Ariel asked real questions and Nick Khan just gave bullshit answers.
He gave worked answers.
For everything. Yeah. Oh, he also said, "We're not looking to sell," which, is basically him saying, "Please fucking buy us, please.
Someone please fucking buy this company."
Yeah, it's so obvious.
Right.
I'm just waiting for them to do it. When is it going to happen? Please. We need this to happen ASAP. We need Vince out of there, please.
Right, you really wonder, how much... Well, I mean, I guess they've sold a ton of it over the past couple of years, but Triple H and Stephanie, cash out all their stock, be like, "We're buying the company right now."
But even if they cashed out their stock, they're not going to have $4 billion worth to buy WWE. That's the thing is, Vince, your dad sold you WWE. Yes, it wasn't worth nearly as much as it is now.
Correct.
But he sold it to you. Why? To keep it as the family business. And now, Vince, you're going to sell it to Disney or fucking US or Universal NBC, ABC, you know, whatever.
It feels like it'd go to NBC.
Sure, or yeah. Disney. The leader, it's got to be NBC or Disney.
Yeah.
But it's like, you know, your dad sold it to you and you're not going to give it to your kids or son-in-law or whatever.
Right.
It's a shame on you, Vince.
Yeah.
Shame on you. All right, on to rumors.
Rumors!
Kevin Owens wins back the Universal title?
Maybe!
Balor Club to finally get a second member?
Too sweet!
Brock Lesnar willingly works a full schedule?
No chance!
Next year's WrestleMania will be in Saudi Arabia?
Confirmed!
According to Wrestling Observer, Becky Lynch requested to be a heel for when she came back, and she's going to be a heel moving forward.
I can see now, that.
Now, it's a little weird because she came out, everyone popped for her.
Uh-huh.
She high-fived everyone in the front row.
Right.
You know.
They've done that before, though.
That's, yeah. But then, like, she talked like a heel on the microphone, but then she cheap-shotted Belair.
Yeah.
All right.
Like, she could be arrogant, like, oh, you love me too much. You need me too much to ever hate me.
Yeah.
And everyone's like, fuck you, in your face.
If she goes back to actually being the man, which is what, when she first turned heel.
Right.
Then sure, I'm for it.
For sure, yeah.
But we'll see. The Observer also reports that Asuka is healthy and available, but WWE is just simply not using her. We have nothing for her. One of the best wrestlers.
Yeah. I mean, ever since her call-up, it's been like that, so.
I asked Asuka for a comment.
Yeah, that sounds like something she'd say.
Yeah, it sure does. I guess that's it for rumors.
Yeah.
So let's get to some fan questions.
Okie dokie.
Boy, do we have a lot this week.
Oh, boy.
Vladimir Jordan, where's the Baron Corbin soundbite? We need it. Too much nonsense in WWE. I promise I'll do it.
Okay.
I just forgot.
Yeah.
We've been busy.
Yeah, it's been a busy few days.
Yeah. Bobby has a new name. Bobby the Mark Soydam.
Okay.
All right, Bobby the Mark Soydam. Not a question, but hope y'all had fun in Vegas. And shout out to Eric for making me laugh with his jokes during my quarantine.
Oh.
Yeah.
You're welcome. So,
there you go.
Yeah.
Thanks, Bobby the Mark Soydam. Appreciate it. Alex Verduzco, who do you guys think needs a heel / face turn? I say Drew desperately needs a heel turn, and Big E should turn once he cashes in.
Yeah.
Those will both work.
Exactly.
Especially Drew McIntyre.
We finally got Miz like being like a real heel.
I would love for Big E to be a heel and stop making love do the briefcase.
Yeah. If he could do that ASAP, that'd be awesome.
ASAP. Jake Bager, Push Fire Barry matches at Extreme Rules. Alexa versus Charlotte. Nikki and Rhea versus Tamina and Natalya. Oh, dear God. And then Brock Lesnar versus Roman Reigns. Custody of Paul Heyman ladder match. Obviously, push that.
Push that. Barry.
Alexa and Charlotte.
Yeah,
fire
the other one.
The tag team match.
Yeah.
David Camp, Survivor Series matchup. NXT Mount Rushmore versus AEW Mount Rushmore versus WWE Mount Rushmore.
Mm.
Who you got? Obviously, WWE Mount Rushmore is going to win. You have The Rock, Austin,
right?
Depending on who's on it, like
I mean, NXT would be Cole, Gargano, Ciampa.
Someone suggested like Asuka or Io Shirai, and I'm totally fine with that.
Yeah,
you know, probably either one of them would be fine for the Mount Rushmore,
right?
And AEW then, would be like you'd have to have Jericho, Moxley,
Omega.
I guess Omega and MJF.
Yeah.
But WWE's going over. Stone Cold and The Rock.
Right, come
Hogan,
on.
Hogan, Ric Flair, if it's... Well, Ric Flair's not WWE Mount Rushmore, but... Hogan, Stone Cold, Rock, and Undertaker, or Mick Foley, Jericho.
Taker.
Taker.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ben Van D, how many more years of Roman matches until he times a Superman punch even somewhat convincingly? Well, if you don't like it now...
Right. It hasn't improved,
I don't think it's going to get any better. Justin Stewart, did you hear that Goldberg's son wants to start training to be a wrestler? Beware of Torque, everybody.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Making his way to the ring. Torque! Torque!
Yeah. Joey Montez, gentlemen, I don't know if I'm asking for much, but I would like a warn... Oh, this is... Joey Montez was asking for the warning before we talk about Spider-Man No Way Home. Because he wants to... he wants to watch the movie not see, having seen any trailer.
Oh, wow.
That's not bad. I respect that. Yeah, I just don't have the willpower to not watch the trailer.
Right, especially with Marvel movies.
Yeah.
I mean, there's so much hype in them, so.
Right. Steve M., visit to Houston was great. Went to Eighth Wonder. Great beer. Thank you for the suggestion. Fuck the Astros. Damn cheaters. I mean, I don't care. I'm not an Astros fan.
Glad you liked Eighth Wonder.
Yeah.
Hope you got some Haterade. I think they have it on tap.
Yeah. That dog has a puffy tail.
Ooh.
Vince.
Where?
AW got Punk. Bring in Becky to squash Bianca and Brock Lesnar. No one will beat us. We'll be better than ever. Vince, hopefully 2 months later. Well, that's the end of me. Great hopefully. Simpsons references.
Yeah.
Their name was a Simpsons reference, and the joke was a Simpsons reference. Adam Wilson with WWE burying Bianca at SummerSlam and making dumb, rash decisions. How long until they put the women's title on Lily the Doll? Well, it could be soon.
Yeah.
Maybe at Extreme Rules.
Right. It'll never be a triple threat.
Because they're... That promo for Extreme Rules, before they said Extreme Rules, I was like, oh, what is this, Halloween Havoc?
Right.
But then it ended up being Extreme Rules.
Yeah.
Strange. Derek Snyder, after Becky's return at SummerSlam, my friends and I got hopeful that we would see the return of Bray Wyatt as well. Oh, boy.
Yikes.
Oh, boy. But to no avail, we've been pondering Bray's options. Go back to WWE. That's not really an option. They don't want him.
Right.
Make the move to AEW, head to Japan, or call it a day with pro wrestling. What do you guys think he'll do? I mean, the hot rumor is that he's going to AEW.
Uh-huh.
That's where everyone goes.
Yeah.
So, I would say that. Rock, Uso, Shawn, Undertaker. Since NXT probably will be irrelevant, will you guys only have a Raw and SmackDown podcast and a Dynamite and Rampage podcast going forward? That's what Josh wants to do, but... I think for now we'll keep doing NXT.
Yeah.
We'll see what they do. Mike Everett, YouTube has a Raw top 10. I've been watching this for the last year. You could watch this and give us your analysis. We would not know the difference. Thank you for taking one for the team. You guys are awesome, except for Josh. Aw.
Oh,
Josh. Nick Godson, does Roman beat Lesnar and then go to Raw to win the championship from Bobby? Probably not.
No.
I wouldn't care. I'd rather have one champion, but...
Right.
El Rey, PJ Perez, how much longer you think until they make Lily a real girl, and who's gonna play her?
Liv Morgan.
I mean, if anyone was... If they were gonna do that, that's the answer.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
She's the only one who could do it, really.
But we haven't seen her since Money in the Bank, right?
Correct.
Like, since she lost. God, we're such idiots. We actually thought they were going to give her the briefcase.
I know, right?
Kyle Foxton. So SmackDown gets John Cena, Becky Lynch, and Brock Lesnar. Raw gets Logan Paul?
USA... Well, SmackDown had Logan Paul.
Oh, before WrestleMania?
Yeah.
But
Cena's gone now.
USA Network must have pissed somebody off.
Brock's not going to be on every episode of SmackDown.
Right. Yeah. Matt Foster, in your own breakaway WWE brand, who would you make your world mid-card tag and women's champions? That's a lot. That's a lot of titles. I mean, I would make Kevin Owens the world champ.
Mm-hmm.
I know that much.
I could do as tag champs.
I'd finally give Cesaro a mid-card title again.
Yeah, that'd be a good
one. Tag champs? I don't know. Are there even tag... Like, what tag teams are even... I mean, Riddle and Orton are tag champs. They should be the tag champs right now.
Yeah, that works.
And women's champs, I mean, Bianca Belair was a good women's champ.
Yeah, Rhea Ripley.
Nikki Cross before she was a superhero.
Asuka.
Asuka, yeah. Mark Horsfield, will AEW beat Raw ratings by 2022?
Sure.
I'll say yes. Rampage did not beat SmackDown, by the way.
But it did, like, the best AEW number since the debut.
Right. Yeah.
So.
Saheen Rahman, do you think Vince heard us when we asked for Scarlett to be back with Cross, so he just gave Cross her ring gear?
That sounds about right.
It's red, too!
Brian, does Andrew not smoke weed? If so, why not? And what's your method for getting through Raw? I should smoke weed.
Yeah.
But then I'll be too out of it to... I'll fuck up the notes. Right.
Someone's got to be level-headed.
Yeah, unfortunately, that's me.
Yeah.
Miles Stacy, when do you think Torque will return to squash MVP and Lashley in a handicap match?
Ooh.
Hopefully ASAP.
Yeah.
Can't wait.
Stream rolls, maybe.
Mitch Tarr, when are we getting these good ideas that Vince was reportedly waiting for?
Right. Yeah, we're still waiting for those.
Still waiting. Pop Culture Junkie, what are the chances Cross showed up for Raw and Vince gave him an ultimatum? Either Scarlett debuts by making out with Vince and becoming his on-screen love interest, or Cross has to dress like the Gimp.
Mm.
I like probably like 90%.
98%.
98%. Yeah. That's good. Yeah. Stone Cold Savage. Anyone else thought that Big E was going to lose his Money in the Bank briefcase to Corbin because they wanted to punish him for fucking it?
No.
Mm.
Not in the slightest.
I still would have had Corbin try to cash in, though. That could
that would have been hilarious.
Would have been funny. Cooper, the super-duper pooper scooper. First, SummerSlam sucked.
Mm-hmm.
Second, I'm getting real tired of commentators saying he must be thinking, what do I need to do to beat blank? I swear they say this shit after every move 2 minutes into a match.
Right. Hit him with a clothesline. What is he going to do to beat him?
Right.
His finisher?
Yeah. Carolyn Holly, there's a video of Corbin gambling in Vegas. If he's broke, then what could he possibly have bet?
He may have done some things that he's not proud of.
Exactly. Yeah, that's probably it.
Yeah.
Dan Hankinson, what could Vince pitch to Adam Cole to stay? You will be champion 24/7. I mean 24/7 champion.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Yeah, he gone.
Yeah, he's not coming back.
I mean, he'd be an idiot to sign with WWE.
They're supposed to be
after seeing Karrion Kross
right
on the main roster.
For sure.
You have to be a fucking idiot.
Yeah. They're supposedly supposed to make him one final offer because I guess his contract extensions till Friday.
Right.
So
yeah.
If people were hoping to see him on, you know, AEW this week, that's a negative.
716, have any of you guys, he probably shows up at All Out.
Yeah.
You know?
That would be cool.
Yeah. 716, have any of you guys ever listened to the Pat McAfee show? I watch clips on Twitter or YouTube sometimes.
Sometimes?
Yeah.
I don't.
McAfee's entertaining. You know, when Adam Cole was on, what, a year or two ago?
Uh-huh.
That was good. But yeah, no, he it's a sports show. It's, yeah.
Sports.
And again, we interviewed like two of his guys in New York for WrestleMania.
Yeah, we did.
Not knowing that they were with Pat McAfee. And Pat McAfee follows our podcast on Twitter because of all that.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah. Jason Dearham, if Seth Rollins beats Edge in their next match, will Seth call himself the Vampire Slayer?
Ooh.
Might as well, right?
Hopefully. Yeah. That'd be fucking cool.
I'm the Brood Slayer, all right?
That I like. The Brood Slayer.
Yeah.
Man.
All right, that is all for the show. So make sure you subscribe to our podcast and give us a 5-star review. Check out our official website, whatswrongwithwrestling.com. Like the show on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Wrong Wrestling. And get a t-shirt at prowrestlingtees.com/whatswrongwithwrestling and become a supporter of the show at patreon.com/whatswrongwithwrestling.
Yeah.
$5 a month gets you everything. Brackets, NXT AEW recaps, all the pay-per-view recaps, all that good shit.
It's actual good shit.
It really is.
This is such good shit.
Wrestling. push Eric, yeah, we'll push him off a cliff. Doesn't think Stacy Keebler is that high, and we almost forgot Josh. He's just a troll. What's wrong with wrestling?